What's up, guys? I thought I'd not try to overdo it this time because that would probably just jinx my video. I'm just wondering what would the proper attire be for an evening out with ASMR, ASMR, however you pronounce it. I've been meaning, thinking about my relationship to suffering, pain and addiction. And it seems that I cannot get any better by experiencing the same sensations over and over again. But I've been trying to make sense of it all by experiencing the feelings in full, right here at my home. And I've been hoping to have some sort of revelation. But I think that when you try your best to chase something, it really doesn't happen ever. So this is why I've given up on the chase. At least my not subliminal mind has given up. But I think that deep down inside I am still struggling and trying to find the way out of this maze. I wouldn't call it a maze, but somehow I always bring myself to ask, what is the amount of suffering to endure, or isolation, or perhaps thinking about losing your mind? All of these things are something that I think I feel very strongly that it's not something you can chase, because that will only lead to more suffering, maybe. Because I'm not sure about my relationship to suffering and addiction and feeling like I'm insufficient in some ways. So this is why it's not gotten me very far by just thinking about it. But I'm hoping to progress somehow, because I always have these weird moments where I get, well, not extremely, but slightly hopeful. I get hopeful that things will be better, or these things are just something for me to experience so that I can learn from them. And there is always the question of ego inside me, well, inside me or whatever, but I think that I'm always like aiming towards a goal that my, I'm gonna say a bad word here, lizard brain has caused me to chase something and be proud of myself. And that is problematic for me, because I've still not let go of all the things that I want to be and want to achieve. When I always, or rather I sometimes feel like when I'm just turning a single closet door, I can feel the universe inside that very moment, and it feels very much, it feels plentiful, so to speak. I think that turning the cupboard, the closet door, or whatever, changing the siphon back on my coffee machine, it feels like the whole universe is contained within those actions, as long as I am present in doing so. Sometimes I'm, or maybe the day is like, most of the time I'm just escaping and trying to flee from these emotions. So whatever I can get, like caffeine, chocolate, sugar, and being preoccupied with social media and getting your likes and dislikes, everything, that is the not the source of addiction, but you can feel it when you are escaping actively and not being able to just feel the, well, not necessarily the universe. You see, I am very green. I am very unexperienced in this field, so I don't really know what I'm after. But I think that it's a lot of it has something to do with feeling fulfilled. That might be the wrong word. I'm not sure about the words. As you can see, English is not my primary language, and nor are these emotions my primary emotions, but it's very difficult for me to find any path to walk on. I just think that those subtle moments when I am present, maybe Eckhart Tolle would call it being present, those are the things that I think that hold a seed of truth, considering the things that I am after. Because sometimes I am like, I'm so satisfied of being, just being on the sofa, and I don't have the ambition to do anything more. And I don't have the ambition to chase like human relationships. And I feel that it suffices. And I feel that the small things, like covering yourself in a blanket during the evenings and listening to some YouTube recording, is all that I need at that moment. And I don't need to chase any grander gratification. So in that moment I think that I might have something, I am chasing something that will consist of these positive emotions. That you should probably disregard me saying it's a positive, because then you are taking it up and you are like raising yourself up to the positive, because when you are naming something to be a positive, then you will always have the negative, so you can fall down and be back at the negative. So you shouldn't really take in the good moments, like you shouldn't be grasping at those good moments like straws. You should really just appreciate what you have. But how to appreciate something without giving the sentient thought of I'm feeling good right now, or the sentient emotion, I want to feel that is my ego talking, that I want and I want and I want. So that is the problem. But these are the things that I am chasing when I'm at home alone and thinking about my relationship to my addictions and my addiction to social media, chocolate and stuff like that. I find that it's not been easy for me. Sometimes the anxiety is like really hard to deal with, but oftentimes I find myself asking that when I am in turmoil, inner turmoil, I feel that there is some way of getting out of those emotions. That's again the ego talking, I think. I'm not sure, I should be more familiar with the ego before taking this any further. The problem lies with me wanting, and I've spent so much time in this single room, just laying down on the sofa with my addictions and my insecurities and my doubts, my fears, my anxieties, my paranoia, which is weird. I don't think that I might have something better coming along my way. I mean, it seems that the want, I'm always wanting, and desperate to learn, but I don't have the patience to learn it. It's a sad affair, I think. Methinks it's a sad affair indeed. But for me, it's a part of the journey, because I wouldn't be making this video. It's been a rough day, as it always is for me, so I don't think that I'd be doing these videos for you guys unless there was something of value. Of course, I am now seeking gratification by making this video, so it's a problem for me. If you were not seeking gratification, shouldn't you just move to a hut somewhere, like a mud hut, you know, in the middle of a jungle? No one would find you there. I think that I won't comment on the afterlife, but I once had a dream that I felt like it wasn't necessarily dying, but a transition. I think that I've been reading a bit of Tibetan Book of the Dead, and I feel that it had something to do with the bardos that are labeled inside, are listed in the book. Because I saw this ancient maze, and it may be of a Mayan origin, I don't care to comment on that very much. But when I was traveling through the labyrinth, it wasn't about the visuals, it wasn't about the sights I saw, the shifting walls, or the traveling I made. It was how it made me feel, like this was something beyond our, not necessarily our comprehension, and not necessarily something that we've forgotten, but something, it had something to do with the afterlife. That is the word I am very hesitant to use, because I don't want this to be a commentary on such things, such as is there an afterlife. But it's still a problematic question for me, because I really thought at that very moment that I was being shown something. I know, somehow I have begun to believe that there is no afterlife. And maybe it is all about me being afraid to die, because I've had these strong sensations of wanting to be dead. But I know that deep within me is still buried some kind of sense of self-preservation, and which gives birth to the fear of dying. So this is why I think that one of my problems is probably not wanting to die, or, well, we shouldn't discuss that at this very moment, because we might or might not want to be, we might or might not want to die at this very moment. But I thought that I want to live, because I've always been afraid of suicide, for example, and that makes me want to believe that if I am afraid of myself committing suicide, I think that maybe I'm deep down, I want to live, even after all the depression, isolation and paranoia. I still feel that it's something I want. Yet again, we are with this word, wanting to live. We don't know how much we have left. We don't know how much time we have left, any of us. So, it's a constant struggle for me. I'd like to be at peace with these emotions. And I'd also like to accept everything that comes. Addictions, insecurities, feelings of dread and insufficient, being insufficient and ugly, and my body, of course, I'm very insecure about my body as well, so it's horrible. All of it is a constant battle. One of the things that I've come to accept, that I will always be somewhat, if not very afraid of everything diseases other people and my opinions being hurtful to someone else and not being intelligent enough to hang around in, you know, social media and give intelligent commentary on anything. And I'm not sure why I should even strive to be something like that, to be someone who is discussing politics or whatever in Twitter. I'm not sure, but a lot of my days goes, a lot of my time I use browsing Twitter or Instagram, and I do think that they are kind of poisonous to me. I'm not sure if you guys have noticed the same. I think that it's a bit bad for me, because I'm always comparing myself to others and seeing how they are taking a lovely vacation or something. Or maybe they have a family, who knows, something that will make me feel the ugly emotion of jealousy. But yeah, I wonder how long I have been filming. I think that we should probably start to stop the video, but let me just move the chair just a tiny bit so that I can be a bit closer to you. But yeah, sometimes it feels like much of my troubles comes from my own routines of forcing myself to the computer and forcing myself to the social media. Sometimes I feel like that is the pain that I deserve. I'm not any, how should I say it? Better is a bad word in this context, but I don't think that I deserve any better than hurting myself through social media and other web pages, which I won't mention here. But I think that a lot of it has something to do with my own self-worth, how I value myself. I think that I want myself to suffer in a sense. My routines are always the same, even though I know it brings me a lot of pain and deepens my insecurities. And if I continue on the path of trying to hurt myself in these manners that I do in this room of mine, I think that we would have to name it the Finnish way, sitten ei hyvä heilu, which means something like there will be trouble. So that is why I should probably change my own routines before things get any better, any worse. I wonder why it's so hard to make oneself make the big changes in your life. It's a lot about me choosing to suffer. Perhaps it's something to do with my self-worth, I think. But these are dangerous words to me. I don't know why should I call it self-worth or self-esteem. I should just take a vacation from social media and my other harmful routines so that I can perhaps not make me feel better, but to have a vacation of sorts from all the troublesome routines that I have in front of the computer. And God knows I've spent a lot of time in front of the computer. My first computer came to this house, or some other house where I lived, back in 1994. So that's probably why I've grown so accustomed to being in front of the computer. Even the role-playing games online, I always sought after acceptance that I felt like I wasn't getting when I was in the outside world, in the real world. So That's what led me to have a bad addiction problem with role-playing games online. But alright, that's it for now. I'm gonna edit this video and I'm gonna publish it on my channel. Thank you everyone for taking this time off with me from the hassle and everyday routines. I'm hoping that I will see you again, but probably not, because I am a very, very lazy person and I don't have the follow-through abilities to make anything consistent. But here is a video of sorts, Finnish ASMR. So, thank you for watching and listening. Have a great day and bye-bye.